NexGen Hearing. NexGen Hearing. The next generation of hearing care.
Welcome back to the News Hour, Tony's last News Hour. He has anchored our 6 o'clock newscast for more than 3 decades. He's supported charities too many to mention. He has won numerous awards, including a Lifetime Achievement Award from the Jack Webster Foundation and a place in the Canadian Broadcast Hall of Fame. Now, I know Tony probably won't like the phrase end of an era, but it is. So we had to put together a look at his outstanding career and a few things you might not know about the anchor you've been watching all these years.
Tony, could you come to the set now? Sound a bit.
Every night, Brian Smalley, our floor director, calls Tony Parsons to the set.
Yeah.
It's a little joke between the two of them, and it's been that way for years. But today is very different, because this is Tony's last news hour.
Last one.
Are you old enough?
I'm okay.
So far?
Yeah, I'm sorry, I didn't say either. Gentlemen, we haven't really...
34 years, 7 premiers, 8 prime ministers, and it all comes down to this. The most watched and trusted face in the province is leaving the big chair of Global BC.
Now, look at this. The fruits of John.
But before he goes, he sat down with me for lunch and a frank discussion about Tony the news anchor, whom everyone knows, and Tony the man, who was a very private person and shy, but obviously not too shy to choose a very public career. Tony Parsonage was born in England just as World War II was heating up. His British father was very strict and away a lot. His Italian mother raised their 6 children, mostly on her own. They moved to small town Ontario after the war, and that's where Tony got a radio job and his new last name, Parsons, from a boss who liked short names. His dad, though, wasn't happy about Tony's choice of career.
Well, at the end of his life, we became friends again, and he never admitted to me that he thought I was successful in what I did because he didn't think it was a job. Because I didn't use my hands.
This is the News Hour.
But his job was very real to viewers of the News Hour.
Here is Tony Parsons. Good evening, BC
Teacher. Tony came on board in 1975 as the newscast was gathering steam and viewers on its climb to number one. BCTV was the new kid on the block in 1960. The number one newscast when the station went on the air was CBS News with Walter Cronkite.
The flag, apparently official, President Kennedy died at 1 p.m. Central Standard Time.
Yes, British Columbians turned to CBS at supper time. No one else, including BCTV, came close for obvious reasons.
So if there's an item that you'd like to know more about, please call us at Channel 8 TV News.
The News Hour with Tony Parker.
But 15 years later, the station that put pictures first went after original stories and always went for the latest technology found the anchor that British Columbians wanted to watch.
The News Hour with Tony Parsons.
Tony had 2 things. One was he had an excellent voice and a good announcing capability, but he also had a calmness and demeanor that commanded attention.
And the most meaningful you can get.
Well, it's all over. It's been one long party here.
Expo might have been over, but Tony's career just kept right on going. He had one of the best jobs in broadcasting, making very good money in a province he loved.
I don't think there's a better, more fun thing to do than what you and I do. I just, I love what I do. I look forward to every day at 6 o'clock. Sure, I thoroughly enjoy it. I think I was so lucky.
Thank you, Brian. That's tonight's News Hour. Good night.